There is a big clean-up ahead with the Student Volunteer Army, among many putting up their hands to help Auckland residents get back on their feet. Our reporter Tessa Parker is in Swanson this morning checking out how they're getting on. Morena, Tess.
Morena, Anna. Well, I've just met up with the Student Volunteer Army. Turns out we're not the only people up at this hour in the morning. I'm here with Jake Parsons, who's from Student Volunteer Army's Auckland branch. You're about to meet up with a whole team of volunteers, hey? What's the game plan for today?
Yeah, so for today, Tessa, we're going to have a whole bunch of people turning up. We're expecting about 40 people to turn up today. We're going to give them a briefing starting at 7 about how to clean up people's homes safely, give them full PPE, gloves, masks, high-vis, and set them up properly so we can do it safely. And we're going to go out to the Henderson community here. We were out door knocking on Monday looking for homes that have been really affected. And so we've found a whole bunch of homes that really need some help. So we're heading out in teams of 4 and we're going to help them out.
Nice. And I believe it's just over around 500 red or yellow stickered homes in Tamaki Makaurau, possibly more after the deluge in the previous days. What kind of scenes have you been seeing while you've been doing this volunteering?
Yeah, so we've been out door knocking and just talking to people and seeing how it's affected them. A lot of them have showed us photos of the time, and we've seen that the floods were coming up to their windowsills, that their houses have been red or yellow stickered, most of their possessions, most of their mattresses have been destroyed, and then they all need to be moved. And so it's just been quite overwhelming for a lot of people. So anything we can do to help, anything the community can do to help is usually really appreciated, and it's been really good to see the response from the community.
Nice. And you said we've got some of the items here that you guys use for your volunteering. So you have high-vis, gloves, masks. Talk me through why you kind of need these a bit. Is it because of the debris and because of that, the waste and destruction?
Absolutely. I mean, the flood caused a lot of damage and a lot of things have washed up, and we don't necessarily know what's going to be in someone's backyard, what's going to be in someone's house, a lot of like smashed glass and things. So we need to be really careful when we're sending volunteers out into the field. So we're going to have high-vis. We have these SVA t-shirts and lanyards to confirm our identities, so we're not just wandering around on trust. We have good safety gloves and some masks for if we're removing carpet, if we're removing hazardous things, just so we can keep our volunteers as safe as possible out there.
And this has clearly been quite a devastating event for so many people. What's it like when you see community come together and the volunteers come together to help people try restore and recover?
It's been so cool to see. Obviously, it has been a really catastrophic event, and it's really affected people across Tamaki Makaurau. But it's been amazing. Like, just from getting out our sign-up form, we've seen 1,300 people sign up who are willing to volunteer throughout the city. Of those, a lot of them have been mobilising over the last couple of days, and we've always had more people showing up than we expect. So people have been really keen just to get involved throughout the community. We're bringing together a bunch of groups even today, from the local board, from Facebook groups, and from student volunteers. So it's been a real mix of people, which has been really cool.
Yeah, that's awesome. And there are so many people who are wanting to help and lend a hand to everyone in these communities who have been damaged by the floods. What's your advice? What can people do to help?
People can check in on their neighbours, for one, and if they want to get involved with us, they can go to Instagram, SVA or Auckland SVA, or sva.org.nz, and you'll be able to find our sign-up form. You can also request help there if you need.
Right. Jake, thank you so much for giving us the information. Really appreciate it. And thank you for all you're doing for the communities at the moment.